Sorry about the shaky camera work, but I'm trying to look where I'm going, hold a cup of hot chocolate and film at the same time. Nearly there. What I don't want to do as well is get caught out in a massive thunderstorm. But anyway, we're here. Kind of hoping that we'll get some footage of lightning coming down. I can see rain clouds just there in the distance. You can see the sort of sheet rain. Well, good morning. It's 20 past 6. No idea what time I fell asleep, but had a pretty good night's kick, really. Right then, guys, well, yeah, it's a beautiful morning. It's not too cloudy, it's very calm. I've taken some nice stills, and one particular one is really good. Anyway, I'm going to strike the camp now, have a quick cup of coffee, and then get on the water and start paddling south. Well, guys, here we go, packed away. Just got to put the boots in the boat, and yeah, push off. Usual rules apply, obviously. Leave no trace if you can. And if you can't, don't bother. It's so calm today. Superb. It's, I just turned, I spin the bow around. See, the eye over my shoulder is where I was camping. Just there over my this shoulder. And it's just so nice and quiet today. And it is literally, I mean, I thought yesterday it was calm. I mean, this is proper calm. Yeah, it's lovely. Here you are, that's what I'm looking at. Now I'm heading basically straight down there for that open gap. See what we can find. What I'll do, I think I might conserve a bit of battery power. I mean, I have got another battery, but I think I'll conserve what I've got. So I'll switch the camera off while I paddle across this bit of open water. And although I must say, that's pretty spectacular. The sun's just started pouring through the clouds here. So I really hope it comes up on the camera. It probably can't wait. Story, never does, is it? it's things like that that make canoeing worthwhile for me. The Canoe pull stroke, which is basically a pull straight through, and at the end you twist up, pull up on the paddle and slice out. And basically that keeps my back of the canoe from turning, keeps the boat going in a nice straight line. And it's a fast stroke, you can really, you know, pick up speed. If you need to, you can really dig in. It's a powerful stroke. It's also the C stroke, where you start quite far out and you pull in and you do a big C, and that C creates your steering and power in one stroke. But to be honest, I find the Canadian stroke the most comfortable. You know, you paddle it all day. I mean, there's no switching involved, you don't even have water in the canoe. I mean, I know with kayaks, you know, there's a double paddle, although they have those ring things on the paddle to stop water dripping back in. It still does drip in, and you know, the boats do get a bit wet. My boat stays pretty much bone dry unless I have to switch paddle sides for any particular reason, but most of my control is done on one side, which for me is great. You know, sit all day paddling along. It's lovely. There's a lot of sort of dead wood, the sort of thing, you know, people spray white and stick in the garden kind of logs. Or if you're from Chelsea, you spend about £5,000 on a piece of wood that someone sprayed white and then you put it in the garden. It's not to say Chelsea isn't a nice place. Footage is always blurry. In this day and age, modern cameras, anti-vibration gadgets. I mean, let's be honest, you can get cameras now. I mean, this one is nice, but you know, like these GoPro thing, you know, HD cameras and all that. If you're riding a bloody BMX through the woods or, you know, skiing down a mountainside, they're crystal clear. So why can't they get any decent Bigfoot shots? It's always blurry. I'll tell you why, because they're fake. There you go, that'll stir up some controversy. Well, some comments fly on the page now. Men in hairy suits, that's what they are. Men in ghillie suits, that's all it is. Sniper out. Shoulder, there's another massive storm coming in. I've already seen lightning, I can hear thunder, and I'm right out in the middle of the lake. Well guys, as you can probably guess, I've decided to ditch it again. I know what you're going to be commenting on, no doubt, you know, you big Jesse and all that, but the fact is there is another storm rolling over the lake. Like I said before, if it's crap weather, I don't enjoy myself, so what's the point? You know, the whole point of me coming out is to enjoy myself. Thanks for watching. Sorry I couldn't stay out longer. Thanks.